A particle moving along x-axis has acceleration f at time t, given by f is equal to f naught 1 minus t upon capital T, where f naught and t are constants. Particle at t is equal to 0 has velocity 0. In the time interval between t is equal to 0 to at the instant when f is equal to 0, the particle's velocity vx is. So now, first of all, the given conditions are: at t is equal to 0, v is equal to 0. This is given in the question. And f is equal to f naught 1 minus t upon t. So now, let's find the time when f is equal to 0. So when f is equal to 0, 0 is equal to f naught into 1 minus t by t. So from here, 1 minus t by t is equal to 0. 1 is equal to t by t. That means t is equal to capital T. Okay, so we need to find the particle's velocity when time limits are t is equal to 0 to t is equal to capital T. So now the function is given to be f is equal to f naught 1 minus t by t. So now we can utilize it. F is equal to f naught 1 minus t by t. We know that acceleration a is given by dv upon dt. So here this will be f is equal to dv upon dt. So this will be replaced. Dv upon dt is equal to f naught 1 minus t by t. Now dv is equal to f naught into 1 minus t upon t into dt. Now we have to integrate. So now at initially, when t is equal to 0, velocity is 0, and when t is equal to t, velocity is, let's say, v. Now we have to solve this integral in order to find out the final expression. So here this will be v 0 to v is equal to f naught is constant, and the integration of 1 will be t minus integration of t will be t square by 2. Limits are 0 to capital T. So this will be v minus 0 is equal to f naught. If you substitute the limit, this will be t minus 1 upon t into t square by 2. And minus, of course, when you put 0, you will get 0 only. So this will be f naught into, this t minus, this is cancelled out, t minus t by 2. So now this will be v is equal to f naught into t by 2. So yeah, velocity at that moment will be f naught into t, capital T by 2. This should be the answer. So let us check. Or it can be written as 1 upon 2 f naught into t. So let us check. Option number 4 says 1 upon 2 f naught into t, which we have just got. So option number 4 has to be the right choice in this question. So not a difficult question, just little bit logical one, in order to find f is equal to 0, corresponding time t is equal to t. That's it. Okay. Yeah.